guys, how are you? Welcome back to another video. So let's start. Today we read about the structure of neuron. Yeah friends, we talk about this video, the structure of neuron. In last episode we know that the all structure of the eye. So in this video we know about the structure of neuron. So let's start. So friends, if you like this video and comment this video, also the subscribe this video and share it. Okay, let's start. So friends, you all can see there are a picture of a neuron in my board. So what is a neuron? The neuron is the structural and functional unit of the nervous tissues, also the nervous system or neural system. So this is a picture of a neuron. Okay students, this is a picture of a neuron. And if you notice, there are two parts of a neuron. The uppermost part is the cell body and the lowermost part is called the axon. And it divides these two parts. And the cell bodies have many types of parts, like this this projection. These are called the dendrons. Also, the dendron divides more projection. These are called the dendrites. Okay, students. So, this is the structure of a cell body. So we write here, the first is the cell body. So first part is the cell body. At first we write it. The first part is the cell body. Okay, it's called the cell body. And also the second part, this is called the axon. This is called the axon. Okay students, this is called the axon. And this is the two parts, the axon and the cell body. Okay, also the cell body have different names, like the neurocytons, also the soma and many types of. So it is the two parts of a neuron. Okay, and please notice in this picture, the cell body, there are very types of projections. These projections are called the dendrons. Okay, the projection is called the dendron. Yeah students, and then this projection divides more and more. So these projections, these divided projections are called the dendrites. Notice this, the divided projection is called the dendrites. It is not same that dendrites, it is not same that dendrons and dendrites. There are different between dendrons and dendrites. Dendrites is divided from the dendrons, and dendrons formed from the axon, from the cell body. Okay, so what is the work of the dendrons and dendrites? The dendron and dendrites receive the impulses or stimuli through it, and it transmitted to the cell body. Okay, transmitted to the cell body. So this projection is called the dendrons and dendrites. Now we talk about the cell body. So in the cell body, like the all cells, there are cytoplasm. This cytoplasm is called the neuroplasm. Okay students, this cytoplasm is called the neuroplasm. And in the cell body, like all cells, there are many types of cells organs, like the ribosomes, lysosomes, fat, globules, pigment, granules, neurofibrils, neurotubules, and many types of things. Also the nasal granules. It is a very important part of the cell body. Okay students, so there are a more important thing. This is called the neurofibers that transmitted these impulses to the axon. Okay, to the axon. There are many types of neurofibers that transmission the impulses to the axon. Okay, and there are nasal granules which help to protein synthesis in the cell body. It give the protein to the cell body, and it also help the protein synthesis. So there are a very important part. So the nasal granules play role as a protein synthesis. So it is the basic work system of the nasal granules. And also there are a nucleus in the cell body. There also have a nucleus in the cell body, in the middle part of the cell body. In this picture, this is the nucleus. So it is the basic thing of the cell body. Now we talk about the all projection. This is called the axon. So let's start. Okay, so next part is the axon. So axon is formed from the most sensitive parts. This is called the axon hillock. This is called the axon hillock. So this is the location of the axon hillock. This part is called the axon hillock. So it is the main thing. So it's called the axon hillock. So from where the axon is formed, this answer is the axon hillock. Okay. Then notice is the projection like structure, and there are many types of projection also that have a thin structure. And please notice there are a and this part is called the myelin sheath. This part is called the myelin sheath. Okay, so this is part, this is called the myelin sheath. In the myelin sheath there are a Schwann cell. It is not look at this picture properly. So there are the Schwann cell like this, this types of things. These are called the Schwann cell, and these are the Schwann cell. So what is the workstation of the Schwann cell? The from the Schwann cell, the neuronema of the axon is formed. So what is the neuronema? The neuronema is the outermost membrane of the myelin sheath. It is called the neuronema. So outermost membrane, this the outermost membrane is called the neuronema. And in this in between thing, neuronema, and this axon, between this axon, there have a outermost membrane. This red separate, this notice in this picture, this red color strip. This is called the axolemma. This is called the axolemma. And in the axolemma, there have a cytoplasm. It's called the exoplasm. It's called the exoplasm. So what is the basic base of the axolemma? This base of the like the 0.3 angstrom. 0.3 angstrom. It is the basic base of the axolemma. Okay, students. So it is the basic thing of the all axon. And also when the myelin sheath is finished, to between two myelin sheath there are space. It's called the adjacent myelin sheath. This is called the node of Ranvier. This is called the node of Ranvier. Node of Ranvier. Okay. This is called the node of Ranvier. So it is the full structure of the axon. There are no doubt, I think. Okay, so now we say about the last part. This is called the axon terminus. This is called the axon terminus. In this picture, you can see there have a group of branches like this, like this. This is called the axon terminus. This is called the axon terminal. Okay, students, this is called the axon terminus. And then axon terminals are divided more branches, and these are called the synaptic knob, and these that are called the synaptic knob. And this synaptic knob attaches with the another neurons, dendrons, means another neurons, dendrons. Okay, and in between the synaptic knob and the dendron, there have a junction. It's called a synapse. It's called a synapse. So it's synaptic knob itself to transmit the impulse to the another neuron. This neuron to another neuron. Okay, so yes. So it is the full structure of the neuron. So what is the longest cell of a human being? If we question, so this answer is the neuron is the longest cell in a human body, because the structure of the this size of the cell body is similar to another cell. But in the neurons there are many types of projections, also processes, and in this reason it looks very long, and it is the longest structure is the longest cell in a human body, and in a human body the number of the neurons is 100 billion, and it is located in the cerebellum of a brain. So it is 100 number of 100 billion of the brain. So students, it is the full video of a structure of neuron. If you like this video, so please like, subscribe my channel, also share this video. So let's end, students. We will meet the next video. So okay, bye bye.